Hi everyone, my name is Mario Cordero and I'm a Cloud Identity Engineer at Microsoft. In today's video, we'll talk about ADFS certificates, so let's get started. Exploration of certificates in ADFS is a common reason that our customers open support cases with us. So today, we're going to explain the certificates used in ADFS and show you how to update them yourself so that you don't have to open a support ticket. There are four different certificates used within ADFS. TLS, Service Communication, Token Decrypting, and Token Sign-In. The TLS certificate is used as a TLS binding certificate that clients will use when connecting to ADFS. The Service Communication certificate is used to secure some of the communication between the ADFS servers. The Token Decrypting certificate is used when a claims provider or relying party trust wants to encrypt some data to your ADFS servers. This is commonly seen in ADFS to ADFS deployments. The token signing certificate is used to sign the assertion that ADFS issues to reliant party trust when auto-certificate rollover occurs. If the reliant party does not monitor the ADFS federation metadata, then the application will likely not accept the assertion from ADFS due to a mismatch in the signing certificate that it expects. Service communication and TLS generally utilize the same certificate issued by a public certificate authority. However, even though they use the same certificate, they are updated using different commands. So once added to the local machine store with a private key on every ADFS server, you can update the service communication certificate by running the following commands. We will first get and copy the thumbprint for the new certificate. And then we will run this command. set-adfs-certificate-certificate-type-service-communication-thumbprint and use the thumbprint we just copied before. You may need to restart the ADFS service after performing this change. Optionally, this certificate can be set in the ADFS console under the certificate node right here. Keep in mind, the ADFS service account will need read permissions to that private key on each server. For the SSL certificate, this can be done via Azure AD Connect, assuming that WinRM has been enabled to each ADFS and web application proxy server. To check the current bindings for the ADFS, please run the command netsh http show SSL. The output may look like this. If Azure AD Connect is not available, then this can also be done via PowerShell after the new certificate is installed in the local machine store on each ADFS and web application proxy server. You may need to get the thumbprint for the new certificate by running the same command. And if you are running ADFS version 2012R2, in PowerShell, you will have to execute the command set-adfs-ssl-certificate-thumbprint and the thumbprint on every node. On the newer versions of ADFS 2016 or 2019, this is a multi-node command. And so on the primary server, it will execute on all the servers in the farm using PowerShell remoting over port 5985. For the web application proxy servers, you will also need to update the SSL certificate by running the command set-webapplicationproxy-ssl-certificate-thumbprint and the thumbprint for the new certificate. This needs to be done on every web application proxy server. For the token decrypting and token signing, when using auto-certificate rollover, ADFS will generate a self-signed certificate based on the following parameters. Certificate duration. These parameters determine how long the certificate will be valid. By default, this is set to 365 days. Certificate generation threshold. This value is the number of days before the current certificate expires and a new certificate is generated. By default, this is set to 20 days. Certificate generation threshold. This value promotes the newly generated certificate to primary after this number of days. By default, this is set to 5 days. So if auto certificate rollover is set to true, these three parameters together mean ADFS will generate a new token signing and token decrypting certificate 20 days before the current certificates expire and promoting to primary after 5 days. The net effect of this is that if the relying parties are not monitoring the IDFS Federation metadata, then we can roll back to the original certificate until we're able to get the relying parties updated. Keep in mind, the IDFS will always sign the assertions with the primary token signing certificate. It may be necessary to roll back to the previous certificate in order to get the relying party trust updated. To do this, we will need to perform these steps. First, we're going to disable the auto certificate rollover by executing the command set-adfs-properties-autocertificate-rollover $false. In the IDFS management console, we will need to highlight the secondary certificate and then select as primary. Please note that the rollover must be completed before this certificate expires. Once the relying parties are updated, please set the new certificate back to primary and the auto certificate rollover back to true to allow for the certificate to return back to the default behavior. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope this helps you demystify the certificates used within ADFS and how to get them updated. For additional troubleshooting guides and tools, please check out adfshelp.microsoft.com.